will be present at a later time at another detector, and simply with the proper mathematics you can analyze the diffusion coefficient.
How close these two foci are?
They are within a few micrometers.
Further questions? Can you somehow use this also for mapping? Let's say there is a structure in which there are molecules which move in a certain structure, let's say the membrane or around the cytoskeleton. Can you use this also for mapping or having an idea about the structure, what is involved in this?
So, as I said, you can find out about the diffusion mechanism, and that can give you a hint whether it's directed motion along, for example, a structural element like the cytoskeleton. But you can also use 2D FCS, and you will get these slides, so you will at least be able to read the slide that I want to show. You can also use 2D FCS if you use selected plane illumination, where with a cylindrical lens you illuminate a light sheet. With a light sheet, a section of the cell. This is not exactly like confocal because here the light is not constricted to a single focal point, but it illuminates the whole light sheet, which is about 2 micrometers thick. And then perpendicular to this, you can place an immersion objective and detect fluorescence intensities as a time lapse with a CCD camera or an APD array. And then in each pixel of the camera, you can calculate a proper correlation function that can give you such a correlation map. Here you see diffusion coefficient distribution in the sand flows with the transcription factor. And this is the fraction of the slow component. So, in principle, you can map differences within a cell or within an organelle. And if you are lucky, you can detect changes.
Thank you. Just one more.